Hello students, welcome to the chapter Inverse Trigonometric Function, lecture number 4. In the last videos, I have discussed the introduction part, some basic results of inverse trigonometric function and some questions based on the results. In this video, I am going to teach you the very important properties of inverse trigonometric functions. Dear students, here I am going to prove the very important properties of inverse trigonometric functions. This property is going to help us in evaluating the inverse trigonometric function with negative values. Try to understand, when the inverse trigonometric function carries the negative values, then we apply these properties. Number one, sine inverse of minus x equal to minus sine inverse x, tan inverse of minus x equal to minus tan inverse x, cosec inverse of minus x equal to minus cosec inverse x. These are the three results with negative values, and you should express them as given in these results, students. The proof of 1, 2, 3 will be now. First one, sine inverse of minus x is equal to minus sine inverse x. The proof of this one, let sine inverse of minus x equal to theta. Let us consider the LHS, sine inverse of minus x equal to theta. You know that theta is lies between the range of sine inverse, that minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Dear students, to prove this, let us have the discussion. Already I have taken sine inverse of minus x equal to theta, right? So here what I'll do, I'll take sine inverse to the right side. So minus x is equal to sine theta. If sine inverse goes to the right side, sine theta. Multiply minus on both the side. Here I am multiplying negative sign on both the side. Then it will be x is equal to minus sine theta. And dear students, we know that in trigonometry, sine of minus theta is equal to minus sine theta. So here in the RHS part, I'll write minus sine theta as sine of minus theta using trigonometric result. Then I'll take sine to the left side, so that will be sine inverse x is equal to minus theta. Again I multiply minus sine on both the side, multiply minus on both the side. A simple method I am writing here to understand. So what happens if you multiply minus on both side? Minus sine inverse x is equal to plus theta. Minus into minus will be plus theta. So minus sine inverse x is equal to, what is the theta value, students? I have taken theta value as sine inverse of minus x. So theta will replace as sine inverse of minus x. Therefore, you can observe, we prove that sine inverse of minus x is equal to minus sine inverse x. Always remember this property, students, with negative values. Sine inverse of minus x is minus sine inverse x. Hope you followed. Let us move into the next. Tan inverse of minus x equal to minus tan inverse x. The proof of this one, let me take tan inverse of minus x equal to theta, where theta is between minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. So taking this tan inverse of minus x equal to theta, let us prove the RHS. Dear students, again I do the same work, taking tan inverse to the right side. So minus x is equal to tan theta. If tan inverse goes to the right side, tan theta. Again multiply minus sine on both the side. This is a simple method. Multiply minus on both the side, so that x is equal to minus tan theta. Again I'll take back to trigonometry. We know that tan of minus theta is minus tan theta. So using this result, now I am going to write minus tan theta as tan of minus theta. Then taking tan to the left side will be tan inverse x is equal to minus theta. Again multiply minus sine on both the side. Same work what we have discussed in the previous property, the same work. Multiply minus sine on both the side, so that minus tan inverse x is equal to plus theta. If you multiply minus, it will be plus. Therefore minus tan inverse x is equal to, replace theta value, that is tan inverse of minus x. Hence you proved tan inverse of minus x is equal to minus tan inverse x. This is also a very important property. Please remember the proof. Like this, we will prove the next result also. Cosec inverse of minus x equal to minus cosec inverse x. Proof: let cosec inverse of minus x equal to theta, where theta is in the interval minus pi by 2 comma pi by 2 minus 0. Taking this, I am going to prove the RHS. Let me take the same work that we have done in the previous property, taking cosec inverse to the right side. So minus x is equal to cosec theta. If cosec inverse goes to the right side, it will be cosec theta. Multiply minus on both the side. The same pattern you have to follow for all the three property students. Multiply minus sign on both the side. That will be x equal to minus cosec theta. Hope you will remember. We know that cosec minus theta is equal to minus cosec theta. So using that here, x is equal to cosec of minus theta. Now take cosec to the left side. What happens if cosec goes to the left side? Cosec inverse, x is equal to minus theta. Once if you get minus theta, what is the work that we have to do? Multiply minus on both the side. Now it will be minus cosec inverse x is equal to minus into minus plus theta. So replace theta here. Minus cosec inverse x is equal to, what is theta you have? That is cosec inverse of minus x. Therefore you have proved that cosec inverse of minus x is equal to minus cosec inverse x. This is also a property with negative. So we proved the three basic properties of inverse trigonometric function with the negative values. Hope you will remember all the three properties and their proof, important for exams. We'll go to the next property. This property, the next property, going to help us in evaluating the inverse trigonometric functions with the negative values again, but the other three are there. Those are cos inverse of minus x equal to pi minus cos inverse x, sec inverse of minus x equal to pi minus sec inverse. The third one, cot inverse of minus x equal to pi minus cot inverse x. You can observe, you can compare these three properties to the previous three properties. Here one extra term is coming, that is pi minus, pi minus, pi minus. So why that pi minus is coming, that we'll see in the proof section. The first one, cos inverse of minus x equal to pi minus cos inverse x, where x belongs to minus 1 comma 1. The proof of this one, let us consider the LHS, that is cos inverse of minus x equal to theta, where theta is in the range of cos inverse, that is 0 to pi. Dear students, follow the same technique, taking cos inverse to the right side, that will be minus x equal to cos theta. Again multiply minus sign on both the side, so that what happens, you see, that will be x equal to minus cos theta. Very important students, remember, we know that cos of minus theta is cos theta. Many students may think cos of minus theta is minus cos theta, but it is cos theta. Now minus cos theta, I will express it as in the second quadrant, that is pi minus theta. So minus cos theta, we are going to write it as cos of pi minus theta. So this I am going to apply here. So x is equal to minus cos theta, I will write it as cos of pi minus theta, because cos of pi minus theta gives you minus cos theta according to trigonometric results. Now taking cos to the left side, cos inverse x is equal to pi minus theta. Now another modification I do here, theta to the left side, cos inverse to the right side, so that will be theta is equal to pi minus cos inverse x, finished. If you take minus theta left side plus theta, cos inverse x to the right side minus cos inverse x. So now you replace theta value, that is cos inverse of minus x is equal to pi minus cos inverse x. Hope you understood this simple property and simple proof. So cos inverse of minus x is equal to always pi minus cos inverse x. This is the first result or the first property. Let me take the next property, the second one. Sec inverse of minus x equal to pi minus sec inverse x. The proof, let us consider the LHS. Sec inverse of minus x equal to theta, where theta lies in the range of sec inverse function. Follow the same technique, students. Taking sec inverse right side, so minus x is equal to sec theta multiply minus sine on both the side. Same pattern, no changes in every property. So that x is equal to minus sec theta. Again, I'll take back to trigonometry. Please remember, sec of minus theta is equal to sec theta. Many students think minus sec theta, but it is sec theta. But here minus sec theta is there. This minus sec theta, I will write it as sec of pi minus theta. This minus sec theta, I will write it as sec of pi minus theta. So coming back to this proof, x equal to minus sec theta can be sec of pi minus theta. Now do the same work, taking sec to the left side. So sec inverse x is equal to pi minus theta. Now the same work that you have done in the first one, I mean the previous, minus theta to the left, sec inverse to the right. So that theta is equal to pi minus sec inverse x. Replace theta value. That theta value you can see here, sec inverse of minus x. Therefore, I will replace theta as sec inverse of minus x, and it is equal to pi minus sec inverse x. Hope you followed this proof. Sec inverse of minus x is equal to pi minus sec inverse x. Please remember the property and the proof of the property. We'll go to the third one in this. Cot inverse of minus x equal to pi minus cot inverse x. Proof. Let cot inverse of minus x equal to theta, where theta belongs to the range of cot inverse function, that is 0, 5. Let me take cot inverse to the right side. Same pattern. Minus x is equal to cot theta and multiply minus sign on both the side. Here I am using this kind of way so that it will help you a lot to understand. Multiplying minus on both sides, so x is equal to minus cot theta. Very important discussion, students. Note, we know that cot of minus theta is equal to minus cot theta, definitely. But I want minus cot theta. I will not write cot of minus theta, students. I am going to express it as cot of pi minus theta, because the range of cot inverse is 0, pi. So I can use cot of pi minus theta. So coming back to the proof, x is equal to minus cot theta can be written as cot of pi minus theta. Note this step. Please don't write minus cot theta as cot of minus theta. Don't use this one. Use cot of pi minus theta. Then go for cot to the left side. That is cot inverse x is equal to pi minus theta. Then minus theta will be left, cot inverse will be right. So that theta is equal to pi minus cot inverse x. Then I replace theta value. The value of theta is cot inverse of minus x. Therefore, cot inverse of minus x is equal to pi minus cot inverse x. Hence, we proved a third property in this pi minus, that is cot inverse of minus x is equal to pi minus cot inverse x. Dear students, remember this property and the proof. At the end, I want to discuss one important note here. What all the three we discussed now so far, just classify them. Sine inverse of minus x is minus sine inverse x. And the second one, tan inverse of minus x is minus tan inverse x. Then the third one, cosec inverse of minus x is minus cosec inverse x. This is one set. Remember, this is one set. Sine inverse, tan inverse, cosec inverse. The another set is cos inverse of minus x. Don't think it is minus cos inverse. It is actually pi minus cos inverse x. The second one in this, sec inverse of minus x. Again, don't think it is minus sec inverse. It is pi minus sec inverse x. The third one, cot inverse minus x. This is also pi minus cot inverse x. These are the two sets of the same property that you have to remember to solve the problems. Hope you understood all the six properties of the inverse trigonometric functions. Follow the same procedure. Thank you, students. We'll meet you in the next video with some more concepts.